Hello, everybody. It's Lumi. I finished it. It's my turn today at the microphone because I want to make sure that my channel doesn't get people thinking that I don't care about you or letting my channel lapse into oblivion. Today, of course, we don't really have a lot to talk about, but I'm sure I'll come up with something. Although, when I was in the bathroom prepping up, I kind of came up with a topic I'd like to address. This term has been mentioned more times in this last few years. I think it's clouded. I'm sorry, I'm just a little tired. It's clouded the whole concept of the original concept. And that is racism. We hear about racism even applying where areas that have nothing to do with race. For example, some people say if you support Donald Trump, you're racist. Or if you support the Republican Party, you're racist. Or if you're anti-abortion, you're racist. If you're pro-business, you're racist. Okay? In other words, the term racism is thrown around like a political football, and it doesn't make any sense. So, first of all, what is racism? Racism is believing that a certain race of people is better than other races of people. Now, the first thing is, with the case of racism, is that, for example, Dr. Ben Carson is a Republican neurosurgeon, and he was Donald Trump's running mate. And Donald Trump clearly was more of the people supporting the candidate, but he still supports and still respects Dr. Ben Carson, and he wanted to have him as part of his administration. Dr. Carson decided to decline. So, because Dr. Carson decided to decline, does that mean that Dr. Ben Carson is a racist? Because he decided not to be part of the Republican administration of Donald Trump? Of course not. He chose not to be part of Donald Trump's administration for a variety of reasons. Something as simple as, perhaps, as he said, he wanted to serve in a different capability than instead of something like the Surgeon General. So that doesn't make him a racist. If you are an American citizen and you're black and you support Donald Trump, does that make you a racist? Of course not. Just because you support a candidate doesn't make you a racist. It's how you carry yourself and how you express yourself in everyday work. If you truly believe in supremacy, that some race is better than another race, that's racism. If you feel, in this case, that the candidate it chosen is a bit qualified because of certain skill sets, that's not racism. Okay? So, like I said, this year we've seen racism used in so many ways that clearly I kind of wonder is if people have actually lost track of what the term racism really means. Now, let's talk about something which is about something that's in the field I like to cover, spirituality and religion. In the last few years of this country, we have seen a lot of Muslims, both Sunni Muslims and Shiite Muslims. Apparently the two groups are basically both Muslim, but they're different groups. Okay? Kind of like Protestants, Methodist versus Presbyterian. Okay? They're both Protestant, or they're still both Protestant churches, for this example, but there's differences in teachings and mentalities, and that affects the way that each look at the spiritual writings of, in this case, Jesus Christ of Nazareth. But they both claim to be Christians. And there's always been kind of a, in the Protestant churches especially, there's always kind of been kind of a, like a, my church is better than your church, or my church is the word uses wrong, and things like that. And as we can see in the case of the Muslim community, Michelle is going to eat these for sure. Well, later. Because I don't think I want to listen to the crunchiness of my microphone when I'm talking. So, the first question is what I'm worried about is radical Islamic terrorism and radical Islamic behavior. Is it the Sunni Muslims doing this because they hate Shiite Muslims? Is it the Shiite Muslims doing this because they hate Sunni Muslims? No, we already saw what happened up there in Canada when a Moroccan, which was a Muslim, attacked a mosque that was full of Muslims in prayer. So the question is now, we already know from the Middle East that the Muslims like to kill each other, okay? Claiming that they're unfaithful to Allah, and that they're infidels. That means not truth, not true faith, okay? And that's exactly what infidel means. Means that you're not teaching the truth and that you are misleading people down a path of evil. It's kind of stupid because it's like, wow, where in the hell do we ever get this idea that it's okay to go ahead and blow up your enemies? I guess it's kind of related to what the Beatles sang in the song Revolution. You know, you want us to give money to our minds that hate, don't you know that you can just wait? Because, you see, the thing is that if we support evil, you're going to get into a real problem. Because one side says they're good and the other side says they're evil. And the other, likewise, conversely, put the shoe on the other foot. They say that your side's evil and that they're good. So it doesn't solve nothing. And so it just makes a giant mess of a simple situation. I would rather see, instead of one judging another person's faith system, is for all of us to focus on things that are much more important in this world, such as making sure to make sure that everybody has a meal and everybody has food and there's jobs for people who need work and that there's a warm place for people to sleep and there's no need to worry about disease and misery. That's what I would like to see more of, instead of worrying about, well, you're a Shia Muslim and I'm a Sunni Muslim, so I'm going to go ahead and kill you because your faith is your infidels. I don't think that makes any sense. Or have both groups go up to the Christian groups and go, well, we're going to kill you personally because we don't like you because you support Jesus Christ of Nazareth and you see him as the only son, begotten son of the Almighty God. Whatever. Okay? You guys are terrible that way. Focus on the issues that affect everybody. That is, we need to make sure that people's needs are met and that their spiritual enlightenment is there. And if you don't like their faith system, that's fine. You don't have to worship their faith system. No one's forcing you to pick sides. But what I want to tell you right now is I humbly ask for all Americans to do this. Do not get angry at Donald Trump for his executive order restricting people from coming in from 7 countries that Barack Obama's own administration said were known to be problematic. He said that he wants to make sure to keep this country safe, but he wants to have create stringent policies to make sure that we don't let the crazy Islamic terrorist nuts come into this country without proper vetting and make sure if they are going to come in this country that they understand that there will be repercussions for whatever they do to hurt another person. And that this country, the Sharia law is not the law of the land. And that they need to respect our country's sovereign laws. And that our country says, thou shalt not kill, thou shalt not steal, thou shalt not covet thy neighbor's goods, thou shalt not covet thy neighbor's wife, thou shalt not take the name of the Lord in vain or use it in a harmful way. Okay? The point here is that's a good portion of the Ten Commandments. Thou shalt respect thy Sabbath. Okay? That's another one. That's not quite as important as the other ones. But the point here is that thou shalt not kill is certainly key piece. I don't care if you call him Allah, Yahweh, Zeus, Apollo, whoever you do, or even Odin, okay? It doesn't matter. The Supreme God, he's still the God. It doesn't matter his name. It doesn't matter what he says. It doesn't matter what he does. The most important thing that he wants you to do is to respect each other and respect him for his divine gift of creating life on this planet. That also means he says, thou shalt not kill. Let's talk about the kill part. You say that because somebody does not worship this almighty God in your way, that they are worthless to you, and you kill them. You're breaking one of the most important rules that God has given in the Ten Commandments, in the book of Deuteronomy. Deuteronomy, thou shalt not kill. Because God gave you life. God can take life. It's God's decision to decide how and when it's going to go. You have the right to do it. It's not your choice. You want to kill yourself, that's not even good. But, okay, if you want to kill yourself, you're going to have to deal with the Almighty. That's clearly a very terminal thing. Some people, of course, do have valid reasons to feel it's time to take their own life. But, you know, in this case, we're not talking about taking your own life. We're talking about taking the life of innocent bystanders who have done nothing to you to do wrong. That is a real major crime to the humanity and to the well-being of the world around you. Okay? And if you need me to explain that to you, then you need to relook at everything that you were taught. Because sometimes it's better to remember that we are the children of the divine mother and father God. And that every single person has a reason to be on this earth. Every single person has a right to have a life, liberty, and yes, the pursuit of happiness. But like I said before, Michelle said before, happiness does not necessarily mean it's guaranteed. Everybody has the right to pursue it, but it doesn't mean you're going to get it. But that's okay. You have the right to pursue it. And not to forget this, let's talk about other forms of mistakes that human beings make. I keep hearing this over and over again on different videos. When it says, thou shalt not kill, that means the same thing when you talk about for animals too. Because sure, if you need to kill a goat because you need the meat, or the lamb because you need the meat, that's acceptable. But if you're going to kill an animal just for sport, just to prove that you can kill, say, a deer or a bear or whatever, and you're not going to do anything with the meat, that's waste. That is insulting to the Almighty God when you do that, when you waste something. There is no honest trophy hunting if you truly are a devout Christian or devout Muslim, okay? Or devout pagan. You know that. There is no such thing as trophy hunting. If you're not going to eat the meat, it ain't worth doing it, okay? The same thing for our pets. People kill animals because, well, I don't need this cat anymore. I got too many cats. I'm going to kill it. one way or another, either by using poison or by using gunshots. It doesn't matter. Or can someone else do the job for you? Thou shalt not kill means thou shalt not kill. What part of thou shalt not do you not understand? Now, if things got bad and you had to eat your cat or dog, well, that's not the same thing again. Okay? That's different. All right? Michelle and I don't want to ever think of eating our cats because they're our friends. They're our family. But, you know, the point here is, give me a wrist. And come on up here. Oh, now, this guy is our friend. He is a happy tomcat. He is being allowed to be what he is. He's a male cat. He's a big boy cat. He's a happy kitty. He's got everything that a tomcat wants. And he prefers to go outside to do his business. But no matter what, who said that we should choose to neuter and spay our pets? There is times when medical conditions is necessary. If the cat has prostate issues, testicular cancer, that's different. That's a health issue. Okay? I think human beings should neuter themselves before they neuter their anyone else's pets. Because if what should we be allowed to breed and procreate when we are not allowing our pets to be happy and do with us things that they enjoy? As much as someone says, well, some cats don't like having kittens. Well, that might be true. But they do have the ability to say, I don't want that. Yes, they do. Cats do have the ability to say, no, I don't want kittens. When human beings, for some reason, we think because we're supposed to be the top dog, that we are going to have the right to control all the other animals of the earth. When it says to be a steward of the earth, it didn't say to become the king of the earth. It doesn't say that. It means to respectfully take care of the animals and the plants. And that's what we have to do. We're taking care of the animals and the plants means cleaning up the kitties, make sure they're groomed, make sure they have food, water, and make sure the basic needs are met. That's all it says. It does not say that we're to take control of the cat and say, I'm going to take away your cathood, your tomhood, because I am too stupidly selfish to allow you to breed without me knowing it. I want you to spend your time with me 24/7, because I'm a selfish star of bastard. Yeah, really. But that's sure, what the promise says, but there's too many cats and kittens. Because we love our cats and kittens, we bring them into our home, we give them everything they need. We give them food, water, shelter. In the wild, a cat like Rusty, which I had here in my hands, would possibly be eaten by a coyote, or a fox, or a wolf. That's because it's the nature of the prey. There is, you know, we human beings take cats in our home because they do great things. They keep the rodent population in check. And actually, they're so much more successful than poisons. That's why in New York City, they're actually working a deal with the feral cats. We'll give you the job. You get a chance to do what you do normally. We'll make sure you have food. You kill the rats and mice. Problem solved. We'll make sure you get your shots. They need their shots. They gotta keep them healthy. That's important. But taking away a cat's right to reproduction. I'm not talking about temporary thing. I'm not talking about putting an IUD in a female cat or giving her the equivalent of the pill. They have that for female cats too, by the way. Or, you know, maybe giving a male cat a temporary vasectomy that can be reversed if it's later decided that we want the cat to have kittens. That can be done too, but it's just more expensive. That helps. Reversing on a man is hard. Never mind that a cat. But the point here is, this cat, let me rest.
Come here, come here, come here. Come on. This cat, and he's being a little stubborn, is our pride and joy. He's our family. He's not our servant. He's not our slave. He's not an it. It's a boy. He's a boy cat. He's an adult Tom. And he's a happy Tom. I can tell. Michelle can tell you that, because his tail is always in the air, and he's happy to come in, and he eats and lays with me, Michelle, and then he does all that good stuff. Okay? I brought that up because here we go with the spirituality stuff, because it ties in. We're saying that God says that we can do all these horrible things to one another when we don't even realize that that's not what God said. You're not supposed to do all that stuff. It's different. If it's for food, it's not for food. Thou shalt not kill. It is very clear. Thou shalt not kill. In fact, he doesn't even give in the Ten Commandments, in the book of Deuteronomy, any kind of exception. But Jesus, however, allows a little bit of exception. But just a little bit. Don't go crazy with it. Thou shalt not steal. That means taking something from somebody else without their permission. May it be a piece of music, a video, maybe a cookie out of a cookie jar without asking is still a sin. S-I-N. That's what it is. It doesn't matter what size it is. It doesn't matter if it's a little piece of cookie or if it's entire somebody's transom that's sitting in their backyard. It don't matter. It only doesn't matter if you're stealing somebody's, program that they created by putting it on the Pirate Bay. I know Michelle has got a couple problems with that because, she needed certain programs that were not available in the stores anymore. And she would have bought the programs, but they were not available. So there is kind of a gray area here. Thou shalt not covet or too strongly desire thy neighbor's goods. Anything that somebody else owns that you really want, the desire to have it for your own, may it be a projection TV or a huge swimming pool in the backyard. Thou shalt not desire or covet. Thou shalt not covet thy neighbor's spouse, be it a wife or husband. It says wife in the book of Deuteronomy, but it still applies. In other words, their spouse is off limits to you. And thou shalt not commit adultery. I know I forgot one. Thou shalt not commit adultery. Thou shalt not commit fornication. Thou shalt respectfully say, I'm sorry, that's off limits. I can't go there. Thou shalt, and it's not actually in the Bible, but it actually is in the Pentateuch, in the Torah. It is rules. Thou shalt not go for a divorce, except on cases of infidelity or immorality, or possibly because the marriage was not properly sanctioned in the first place. That is not meaning that it's because you don't like somebody that you can, and it didn't work out, that you should divorce them and go marry another. In Christianity, we see a lot of that, don't we? We see this over and over again, especially in the heathen areas. It's like in the state of California. We see this all the time. This one's going out with this one's wife. They're having an extramarital affair. This person gets that person pregnant. That person then goes ahead and aborts the baby. So now, not only did you commit adultery by going out with somebody else's partner, she goes ahead and commits a mortal sin by killing her unborn baby. And you people talk about why sometimes this world is all messed up. Because part of the reason is the devil, the great deceiver, has been lying to you all, telling you, it's okay. It's not okay. The Muslims know that. The Catholics, which Michelle is, knows that. The Lutherans know that. The Baptists know this. The Presbyterians know this. The Methodists know this. The Congregationalists know this. The Calvinists know this. The Gnostics definitely know this. It's not right. It's not cool. But the devil knows that he can easily mislead somebody when he's saying one three-letter word. But, B-U-T, or however, or in consequence, or nonetheless, all these words he slips in to his little stuff to specifically make you think it's okay. It's not okay. It's not. It's not right. I would humbly ask all Muslims, and I am sure that in my faith system there is some Muslims who watch my videos, and you know what I'm going to tell you. I ask you to stand up for what is right and true. Do not allow this behavior of radical Islamic terrorists to continue. You know who they are. You know why they're doing it. I ask you to speak up against it and tell them firmly that you will not tolerate it anymore. If you radical Islamic terrorists were not so gung-ho going to do everything that was against Muhammad and do all those horrible things, then there would be no reason to have such an executive order placed upon 7 of your countries. Because there would have been never a reason to do it in the first place. But until you people can agree to stop the baloney and do the right teachings of Muhammad, which came to Mecca, incidentally, to give you a way to bring peace to the Saudi Arabia territory of the Middle East. You guys, if you followed what he truly said in the original writing of the Quran, not the modified one, there's a whole other set of Quran, apparently, that was written later on that starts creating these policies that you guys teach, okay, about women and Sharia law and all that. The first of all, Muhammad was very clear that he sat in his cave with the working very hard to understand how he could bring peace to your region. And the most important thing he would tell you is the same thing, is be excellent to one another. Live a good quality life example. Do not do strong drink. Do not use strong language that is meant to hurt or cause problems to other people. Do not backstab. Do not do these evil things, but rather to focus on the needs of the divine God, Allah, Yahweh, Yahweh, whoever you want to call him, Zeus, Apollo, Odin, whatever your God is, to live a good example. And that is what you have to do. It's what this world needs. This world, finally, under President Donald Trump, we're starting to see that the Almighty God whatever name you choose, is taking control and saying, I have had enough of all of this baloney that my antithesis has done. I'm talking about the Satan, the liar, the cheater, the deceiver. I want to make it right, and I have appointed a few select people to bring the light back to the world in the many years, including Moses, Muhammad, and maybe even a few others I can't even think of right now. But the point is that a few select people are brought into this world to bring peace and a message of hope. And I'm going to add the contemporaries, including Mother Teresa, and I might as well add Donald J. Trump to that list. For there is a prophecy out there. You can look for it on YouTube. That's why I watched it. There's a prophecy that says Donald Trump was appointed by God to bring the American people back to God. Okay? You can look it up. It's out there. I don't remember what video it is, but you will find it. So just look for the Trump prophecy. It was given by a retired fireman. Very, very interesting. Okay, so the main thing is for right now is I want you to think about what I'm saying. I'm sorry we didn't get the interview with the gentleman I wanted to get the interview with, but he's obviously is not here. And talking to him earlier with Michelle, something's really upsetting him. We don't quite understand exactly what it is, but, you know, clearly with his mind being on other things, it was decided that it'd be better to try to get him on camera another day when he's a little more calmed down. So we'll try to get him on soon. I think he's a really fantastic guy. You've actually met him once or twice on Michelle's show. His name is Mike Vitale. He is a highly... very devout spiritual person. He has of his own way of looking at the way the works of God and Jesus is, of course, different than me and Michelle's ways, but that's okay. We can have the dialogue. It's not saying we're going to hurt you to listen to what the other side's saying. You just, you know, if you don't like it, that's fine, but you don't have to go ahead and, you know, be negative about it. But I still would love to have him on, but give it some time. Maybe he'll be on in a couple of days. But for now, that's all. Oh, yes. I don't have the little blue square that Michelle does. Oh, dear God. What? I really got to add one. Wait, you can add one. I don't want to use your square. Oh, please don't. I thought we'd agree with you. I thought we did too, but I don't remember where it is. Yeah, we did. We did create one for me. Yes. Okay. There's a little square in the bottom of the screen. I think it's still installed. Just click on it, and that will help you to get to my channel. To subscribe there. It's really easy, and of course, I'm always open to your comments. So thank you guys for watching this. Hope to hear from you soon. Stay safe. In this crazy world, we know that things will eventually be sorted out and the cosmic scales will balance. But when that's going to happen, I don't know. Okay? Bye-bye, everybody. Bye-bye, guys.